Welcome to Learn Computer Technology.
Learning outcomes. Understanding of Azure DevOps. Installation of add-on or extensions in Azure DevOps. Working with Azure Git Repo. Creation of ASP.NET project in Visual Studio. Creation of Azure ARM template project in Visual Studio. Creation of Azure DevOps pipeline. Creation of Azure DevOps release. Deploy infrastructure in Azure Cloud through Azure DevOps. What are Azure DevOps extensions? Extensions are add-ons we can use to customize and extend our DevOps experience with Azure DevOps. They're written with standard technologies like HTML, JavaScript, CSS. These extensions are developed using preferred development tools. These extensions files and assets get bundled to make a Team Extension Service Package, VSIX file, that's published to the Visual Studio Marketplace. From the marketplace, extensions can be installed directly by users. How to install extensions in Azure DevOps? Extensions are simple add-ons that can be used to customize and extend our experience with Azure DevOps. The marketplace is home to hundreds of extensions that can be installed to help with the following tasks: planning and tracking of work items, sprints, scrums, and so on. Pipelines, build and release flows. Code testing and tracking. Collaboration among team members. In the Azure DevOps marketplace, we can do the following tasks: discover and install extensions for Azure DevOps, Visual Studio, and Visual Studio Code. Register Visual Studio Dev Essential subscriptions. In marketplace, most extensions are available for free to use. We can easily add extensions to our organization by simply following these steps. Sign into our organization, https://dev.azure.com/our-organization. Note: our organization name is As Cloud's Home. It may differ as you give your organization name. Select Gear Icon Organization Settings. Select Extensions, and then browse Marketplace. Search Extension Replace Token to install. Note: we will use this extension in our pipeline. Click on it. Then click Get It Free. Select our organization and click Install. Then click to proceed to organization. Check in organization settings replace token extension as installed. What is Azure Repository? Azure Repos is a set of version control tools that we can use to manage our code. It uses Git, an open source version control system used for source code management in software development. Git is not specific to Azure DevOps, a set of collaborative software development tools. In fact, it's used by many platforms that provide source control hosting as a service, like GitHub, GitLab, AWS CodeCommit, Bitbucket, etc. Steps to create Azure Repo. Navigate to the Repos page in our project. From the Repo drop-down, select New Repository. In the Create a New Repository dialog, verify that Git is the repo type and enter a name for our new repo. I made repository by name WebApp Project _CICD. We can also add a README and create a gitignore for the type of code we plan to manage in the repo. When we're happy with the repo name and choices, select Create. A new empty Git repo is now created in our project. Steps to clone the Azure Git repo to our computer. To work with a Git repo, we clone it to our computer. Cloning a repo creates a complete local copy of the Azure Git repo for us to work with it. Cloning also downloads all commits and branches in the repo and sets up a named relationship with the repo on the server. Use this relationship to interact with the existing repo, pushing and pulling changes to share code with our team. Select Clone in the upper right corner of the Files window and copy the clone URL. Open the Git command window, Git Bash on Git for Windows. Run git clone followed by the path copied from the clone URL in the previous section, as shown in the following example. Git clone https://azcloudshome@dev.azure.com/azcloudshome/webapp/_git/webapp-project_CICD. Browse to the folder where we want the code from the repo stored on our computer. What is Microsoft Visual Studio? Microsoft Visual Studio is an integrated development environment from Microsoft. It is used to develop computer programs, as well as websites, web apps, web services, and mobile apps. It includes a code editor that supports syntax highlighting and code completion using IntelliSense for variables, functions, methods, loops, and LINQ queries. We are using Visual Studio Community Edition for this project, which is free to use. The alternative of this is Atom IDE, Visual Studio Code, Eclipse, and NetBeans. Steps to create a ASP.NET Core web app project. Let's open Visual Studio 2019. Select Create New Project. Search ASP.NET Core web application. Click Next. Location Desktop Web App Project _CICD folder. This is our Git clone folder. Check Play Solution in same directory. Give project name Web App. Click Next. Select Target.NET Core 3.1 Long Term Support. Authentication Type None. Checked. Configure for HTTPS. Click Create. It will create our ASP.NET project. Open default index file in project and change the content to Welcome to ASP.NET with ARM template and CICD production. Click on IIS Express button to check that our project is running locally. Right-click on Project Solution and select Add New Project. Search Azure and select Azure Resource Group, then click Next. This module will appear on your Visual Studio only when you have installed Azure package to your Visual Studio installation. Give project name Azure Web App, leave all as default. Click Create. Select Azure Template Window. Select Blank Template, then click OK. The project will be created. Open Azure Deploy.json. Right-click on Resources on JSON Outline Window and click Add Resources. Select Web App and Create New App Service Plan Server Farms. Assign a same name, Web App. An ARM template will be added to your project. Delete variables section and change parameter at two places, where these variables are called in ARM template JSON. Open Azure deploy.parameters.json file and create two variables. Hash web app hash and hash SKU name hash. Right-click on Azure Web App Project and click Build to build this project. Working with the code. In this step, we'll make a change to the files on our computer, commit the changes locally, push the commit up to the repo on the server, and also view these changes there. Switch our directory to the repository that we have cloned. Use command cd webapp project underscore CICD. Keep this command window open, because we'll use it in the following steps. Run command ls to list files of folder. Run command git status to get the status of Git. Run command git add dot to add all files to the Git. Commit our changes by using the following command in the Git command window. Git commit hyphen m double quotes initial commit double quotes. Push our changes up to the Git repo by entering the following command into the Git command window. Git push. Switch back to the web portal and select files to see that our all codes have been pushed to Azure Git repo. Search for azuredeploy.json file in Azure repo. Then check azuredeploy.parameters.json. These are same as our files in Visual Studio. Move to WebApp folder and search for index file. It is also same as our index file in Visual Studio. Watch Azure DevOps Pipeline in next coming video, soon.
Hope you have learned and understand the topic. Please like, share, subscribe and express your views in comment for our motivation. Thanks for watching.